Could you talk a little bit about the cinematography and the, just how you got all those amazing shots?
Well, I did, working with a lot of different filmmakers, you know, leading up to 2008 was really the training I had, and all of it was in the field. I never studied filmmaking or, you know, cinematography to be a cinematographer, but it kind of evolved out of my photography. But really I was getting taught like how to capture sequences, basic things, you know, establishing shots, all those things. And then it evolved as you kind of build your repertoire, different camera moves. And, you know, I was familiar with, I shot a lot of climbing. And so, you know, we really, like I said earlier, we really tried to capture those moments on the climb, but we also tried to capture the moments in between and just get like what people look like when they're sitting in a portaledge for 5 days, you know? And I also learned, you know, that you hold the camera. I mean, we couldn't burn footage, but, you know, I did know, and Renan and I talked about it. It's like you hold the shots because it's like the moment before or the moment after, you know, people think you're rolling, that they, something happens. And so we did focus on capturing some of that, but, you know, it's usually, you want to show the exposure, you want to show details. It's kind of like a photo essay in a way you approach it too, you know? You want to cover it in these different kind of distances, you know? So.
But can I just add to that? I mean, I can't stress to you how extreme this, like the filming was. Like, you know, they would, like one of the things like we saw in the edit room was that because of the altitude, the takes are short because you're holding your breath while you're shooting. Okay, so you're like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you see the camera heat. Like, and so just our material to work with is just, it was different than on other docs because of these, of the conditions. And, you know, the concept that, what also always strikes me is when you talk about how you save a card and a battery for summit day. You know, yeah. it's like this little stash so you don't burn through it before you get there.
Yeah.
And this idea of like you can't recharge your batteries on the mountain.
Yeah, so you ration everything, yeah. Just like the food, essentially. And there are moments too, you know, like you're trying to switch cards out with gloves on and it's negative 20 degrees and snowing. And you're like, don't drop the glove.